Hello, okay, so I created this semi-abstract landscape with watercolours and I decided to crop it, which I quite often end up doing with my landscape paintings. So today I'm going to run through how I made this painting, and I did this by building up the layers of the watercolours. Okay, so let's get started. Okay, so I put these colours down in my sketchbook before, it's a bit rough, but what I've got is I've got Winsor Violet and Burnt Sienna, and I mix these together to make this kind of pinky brown colour. And then the other two colours I've got are Paynes Grey and Cadmium Blue. So it's just literally those four colours. Okay, so I'm using Archer's cold pressed fine grain paper. So I've just taped the side of my paper there because I know that I'm not going to be going too much towards the top. And I'm just doing wet on wet work there. And I'm doing a layer first of this pinky brown colour. And I'm doing it very light because I'm going to be building up my colours from light to dark. So I'm going to be using a mix of wet on wet and wet on dry. And that's going to give me either soft edges or hard edges. Okay, so the paper's still wet and I'm putting on some cadmium blue now. And I'm leaving an area of white in the middle because I know that what I'm trying to achieve is a painting with some mountains and then a kind of body of water in front with the sun reflecting at the horizon line. So I'm going to be leaving a white strip at that horizon line. Okay, so I took the paper off the block at this point because I wanted to be able to move it around a little bit more easily. So the painting is still wet and I'm going to go in with some Paynes Grey. And I'm just going to put the shape of a mountain there. And as you can see, the paper's wet, and so that Paynes Grey is moving across the page in a kind of diffuse way. And I'm not doing too much to it. I've just let it move across the page as it wants to. Now I'm going to do another line of the Paynes Grey at the bottom, and I'm still working wet and wet. So again, this is going to sort of move across the paper in a kind of diffuse way. Now at this point I noticed that I was getting a bit of a bloom where that Paynes Grey is hit the pinky colour, and I don't want this bloom, so I'm going to try and blend it in a bit to the background. So although you don't want to mess around with watercolour too much, it is definitely possible to correct mistakes as you go along, and as you get used to the watercolours you just get more and more used to what you can and can't do in this way. Now, to get rid of that bloom, I'm getting a bit of water on my brush, but not too much. And I'm just trying to kind of blend that in. And as you can see, that is getting rid of that line that the bloom created. Okay, so I waited for all of this to dry, and now I'm going to do a bit of wet on dry work with my Paynes Grey. But then afterwards, I'm going to soften that edge with some water. So this is a way to get a diffuse edge, but with more control than you would have if you were working wet on wet. Okay, so I'm carrying on adding my layers, and I use a little bit of wet on dry, but I mostly use wet on wet, and I also use my knife to make some lines in there to suggest the mountains. So I'll just put the music up for a bit while I finish off this stage, and then I'll talk a bit more about how I decided to finish the painting off. Okay, so I'm really liking the way the painting's looking, especially when it's cropped like this. But I'm actually going to flatten it by wetting the back and putting it under some boards, and then I'll come back to it and decide how to finish it off. Okay, so I left this overnight and it's flat now, and I'm going to get my frame and put it back on and just have a think about how to finish this painting off. So I really like that blue, but I'm going to bring it across a bit more so that I have more of it in this frame, because I'm going to crop this painting. So I'm going to make that white reflection look a bit narrower and put a layer of blue in the foreground and maybe a bit more of the pink in the sky. And I'm also going to be a bit daring and add a bit more brown in the foreground, just to sort of experiment a bit more with my colours. So while I do this, I'm going to put the music up. Okay, so this is more or less finished. Now there's just this mountain to the left, which I think is a bit distracting, so I'm going to just alter the shape of it a little bit and make it a little bit flatter. So I'm just doing this by wetting the paint and dabbing it off with a cloth. But overall I'm pretty happy with this painting, and I'm going to crop it down so that it fits within the mask, and I'm going to also flatten it again overnight, and I'll bring it back and just have a look at how it's looking. Okay, so that's it. This painting's flat now and I've cropped the edges, so I'm pretty happy with how it's turned out. It's been more time consuming than some of my more simple paintings because of the layers, so I hope that you've enjoyed this demonstration, that you found it useful, and if you decide to give something similar a go, then let me know in the comments. And if you did like the video, then please hit the like button. And if you want to see similar videos in the future, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, thank you. Bye.